All right, guys, I'm back. Now I am going to take a look at and see if there's any other coins we can begin to get. So this might be a longer video, but I want to kind of show you what is behind the scenes. Oh, wow, look at this. Oh, wow, look at this. And this, well, don't worry about that right now. But yeah, look at this. Nice, this is crazy. Oh, so happy. Okay, no, I know it's not much, but you know, when we get to 3k and then we get to 4k, I think we're gonna keep going till we get to 5k or 10k, you know, whatever. But let's just look at Spot Wallet right now. Nothing really going on right here. Let's go to earn, and here we can see that, yeah, we have nothing much going on right here, but look, we have this now. So we just focus on this. We don't need to really focus on this right now because most of you don't know how to calculate the equity value in Bitcoin. So let's just focus on that right now. Yeah, I'm really getting excited. Okay, let's look for other coins. So to do that, we go to the markets, and if we want to trade, we trade, but don't worry about the trade right now. Focus on the markets. And what I did right now, I went to home because I want to check out, sorry, I want to check out the ranking list, the gainers and the losers. Yeah, I'm actually at the gym right now, so in case any of you are wondering, you might hear some other sounds and stuff in the background, and I might start to breathe really heavy. I might be a little bit out of breath, but that's completely normal because I need to exercise as well. You know, you make money, but you also have to take care of your health. So, losers, we take a look at losers. So we have cover, FIO, oh sorry, that's just three of those, oops, keep doing that. Oh man. If I move this over, maybe would it help? No, not sure what's triggering that. Anyway, and then there's the mana, and then we have, oh, how come there's four of these actually, and then we have mana here as well. So we have mana, and then we have like these two together, right? Yeah, anyway, just for fun. Okay, so gainers, these are the ones who are gaining today, and these are losers. So usually I look at the losers and maybe see what potential there is. And obviously you can take a look at the 24-hour volume as well. This is a good indication. Oh, one other thing is you also take a look at other places like CoinMarketCap and CoinGecko. Let me show you that right now. So here we have CoinMarketCap, which you have seen before. I think I showed you before when I was taking a look at it yesterday on the 4th. There's a whole video on this as a look at the markets just in general. And remember yesterday, Cardano was around here, right? And then Polkadot was like here. And then Tether was up number 2. This was number 2, but now it's number 4. Cardano is back to 3. Binance was 2 a while back, but now it's kind of down to 5, right? So you see the numbers here. I'm watching all this on the mobile phone, so these are the top few here. So yeah, you can see the volume also. I look at this a lot, look at the volume, and you know, volume actually obviously has gone down a lot, but this is important, right? And when you start seeing negatives, you start to wonder why. At least I do. So we see that this couple here clumped up, and this is negative as well. So the red is Red is negative. And so this is kind of going up and down because of the lawsuit, I think. But yeah, people are saying it might go to 4 or 5 digits. Who knows? We'll see. I'm not really buying into it right now. Like, I wouldn't buy into this because that's like not a very wise thing, and I don't want to just buy one coin, right? I can just put, you know, I can just put like 5,000 in one coin, and when it goes up, it goes up. But that's not what we're doing. We're trading. We're not just buying and holding. Even though we bought and staked, staking is different than buying and holding. And I'll explain that in another video. Okay, so also this one, it was red just now. So you look at what goes red, like these. Those are red just now. So just keep looking at it. And XRP is really fighting. I can see it's really fighting. So again, everything that I say here is for entertainment purposes. It's not financial advice. I'm not suggesting you buy this or that coin. I'm not recommending any of these. I don't even buy these coins on our current crypto venture. I'm not going to buy any of these coins, except maybe Binance, because right, you kind of need Binance, because it's on Binance, you need that coin to do all kinds of cool stuff. But besides that, like even this, like this, I wouldn't consider a real coin. It's basically is a exchange coin, and this is a stable coin which I only use to keep money between trades, so it doesn't go up and down too much. But yeah, any of these other coins, I'm not getting them at all. As far as I know, today I'm just getting into it right now, and I'm not going to buy any of these coins. I'm just saying it out right now, and maybe I'll change my mind later on. But at this point, I'm not going to get any of those coins. So let's take a look at the market. Okay, so one thing is to look at the 24-hour percentage and the 7-day percentages. So these are all the coins that has gone down in the last 24 hours. 6%. Not too shabby. You know, Mana is a good one actually. I might shortlist that. We'll see. This coin I really want to get at some point, because this goes with DOT. Flow is good as well. But a little expensive on the side. On the expensive side. And obviously NEO is good as well. And currently this project on Chios, and I'll show you that on Binance afterwards. Okay, so let's go take a look at the 7-day market percentages. So in the last 7 days, Chios has been really high. It's 100+%. 100+%. That's crazy. ENJ, not bad. Flow, good as well. Tether. Mana, Terra, Luna, and Bancor. Bancor is really good, but it's not too bad, it's not too expensive. Alright, let's keep going. Let's look at CoinGecko. Okay, so this is CoinGecko. And here we see basically the same stuff. I'm just going to take like 1 hour. 1 hour, these are the coins that are going really well, and these are the ones that are losing. So this actually looks interesting. Again, you know, don't buy what I'm saying. I'm just taking a look at it right now. I'm not even thinking of buying anything at this point. I just want to see what is out there and what is doing well and what is not doing well. So some of these projects I know of. This is a really cool project as well. I'm talking about projects, not necessarily the costs or the losses all the percentages in the last 24 hours. AMP is interesting. I never really looked into this, but it's very, very cheap, quote unquote. This is pretty cool as well. I might get some. I'm not sure. We'll see. And then this keeps showing up so everywhere. And obviously IOTA. IOTA is big. I'm going to do a separate video in the future about IOTA. Alright, so let's keep moving. So these are the losses in the last 1 hour, in the last 24 hours. Let's take a look at the losses. Okay, so again, ENJ, Chills, Flow, and what is MDX? Not too familiar with that. I think it's starting to bounce back anyway. So these two are starting to bounce back. You know, because we only have $2,000, we can't really buy too much. For example, we can't buy this coin, because, you know, like buying 10 of them is like more than what we have in our wallet. NEAR seems interesting. This is a pretty good one. So yeah, you can actually get the wallet, the coin gecko wallet. I'll just close that window. And this looks interesting also. I'm not sure how good or how bad it is. Let's take a look. Let's just, so when you go into the coin, you can take a look at the percentages here, right? See many ads. I apologize. This is also really important. Market cap, the high lows, all that really cool stuff. The circling supply, max supply, and the trading volumes. And obviously, you know, check out the website, and if you have any transactions, you can check out the explorers, you can check out the wallet. Community, very good idea to do that as well. And if you're a programmer, coder, you can check out the source code if you want on GitHub. This is currently 29. The rank is 29 on market cap, so it's pretty good, pretty solid. And let's scroll down to the charts. Yeah, what I like about this really is you can enter like how much you want or have and convert it, see how much it's actually worth in USD, for example. So I'm going to say 100. Sorry. 100 is actually, yeah. Because there's no, it's basically $12 each, right? So it's like, you know, $1,200 and 62. $1,262. So here we have the charts. This is obviously the 24 hour chart for 7 days, 14 days, 30, 90 max from the beginning of time, meaning from the time it was listed, or even before it was listed on exchanges. So let's take a look at the 7 days. So, you know, I look at the bottoms, I look at the peaks, and if there's any patterns. Not looking at the bands or anything right now, but we'll look at the detail later on if we want to. So again, these are very important information. And here's about the coin. Let's scroll down to read about the coin. So this is interesting. It says proof of history. So we have all kinds of proofs, like we have proof of stake, proof of work, proof of this and that, and here we have proof of history. Cool. So this is more about proof of history. What this is about. This is the architecture and that kind of stuff. And this is really cool. If you're into TradingView, check it out. So right now TradingView seems to say you should buy this 5 sells, 9 neutrals, and 12 buys. Let's take a look at it. So this is tied to USDT, as you can see here. USTT and Binance. So this is usually if you're on TradingView, you take a look at Binance. Especially if you're trading on Binance. Okay, who adds? No. Okay, ooh, look at this chart. Alright, so see, beginning of the year, it was just around here, which is around $2, and now it's gone up to what? $12 is here right now, right? 14 is here, 16 is here, approximately. 10, 8, 6, 4. So basically, if it's $2, it went to 4. And then it went to 6, actually 4 to 8, and then 8 to 16 exponents. Math! Yeah! You gotta love math. Alright, so let's look at tentacles. So we have all kinds of different tentacles. We have 15 minutes, 1 hour, 4 hours, 1 day. It's a summary, pretty much buy 6, 10, 10. And check out the oscillators. Neutral, is 9 neutral, I guess. Moving averages, MAs, very important, 4, 1, 10. So this is really interesting. If you want to get into all the math and all the other technical analysis and TAs, and check it out. Relative strength index, the RSI. Yeah. Alright, cool, cool, cool. So moving averages, basically these two are for sell, the rest are for buys, and another two for sell. So we have 4 sells and the rest are buys. Interesting. Cool. Okay, let's go back to Binance. Okay, we're back at Binance. So I want to take a look at the chart for Sol. Solander, S-O-L. And here you can choose which one you want. Which is it paired to USDT or Binance's US stablecoin, or BNB, which is Binance's coin, or BTC, which is Bitcoin. And notice that, you know, this is like 2.37%, 2.25%, 2.13, and 4.26%. All right, and futures, you can get futures, but I'm not going to get futures. So I'm going to go to, because right now we have this, so we're going to go check it this out. Let's go. Okay, so this is the 15-minute chart. We'll take a look at 1 hour, 4 hours, and 1 day. Okay, so this is 15 minutes, right? 1 hour. Ooh, 1 hour, look at this. It's gone down. It's gone down, okay. Let's look at 4 hours. 4 hours, not too bad. It's like up and down. It's like down, up, down. Bad color. Down. Actually, this is, how do I make this more bold? I'll just use white, I guess. So this is going down, it's going up, it goes down again. So it's like a little nice little shape there. And then let's look at 1 day. So 1 day is still pretty much up all the way until here, and then it goes down. Then it's like starting to go sideways a bit, but still on a downward trend. This is not technical analysis, I'm just looking at it my way. So you can look at the EMA, the Bollinger Bands, volume, the MACD, RSI, and then the KDJ. Interesting. Okay, so I look at the depth usually to see how much is being bought and sold. It's not showing it right now. So let's go back to 1 hour, 15 minutes. Weird, it's not showing up. Okay, never mind. Keep going. So it's kind of high right now. So I'm going to pass on this one. Alright, so we can also look down here. It is number 28 now. So it's kind of going up. Market cap, circulation, max cap, total supply, etc. Alright, I think that's it for this one. I'm going to keep looking on my own. I think I'm just trying to explain a lot of things as I go along. Hopefully this helps. Let me know if it helps. And I'm going to post it in the comments. And I'll catch you in the next video. I'm going to move on to another part of the gym. Alright. I apologize if I sound like I'm panting or trying hard to breathe. I am working out and the body does what it does. So I'll catch you in the next video. And yeah, remember to like, subscribe, follow, hit the bell if you're subscribing for the first time, or if you've been watching my videos, hit the bell so you get notifications. And love to hear comments, and please share with friends. I'll catch you in the next video. Thanks again.